Hey guys, Prangell Gaming here. Welcome back to the Millwall Career Mode. It's Season 1, Episode 22. And no matter what, the first season will be ending today. Obviously, we have three games with the potential of playing four. So the first one is against Manchester City at the Etihad Stadium in the semi-finals of the FA Cup. I am so looking forward to this game. I cannot wait. It's going to be one of those that we've got to be very sceptical as we haven't won in 90 minutes in seven games. And it is an opportunity to get Everton or Manchester United in the final. So that's something that we don't want to overlook. Anyway, into the final two league games, which is a real big importance. We have Bury away from home and then Oxford United at home. Now, the thing with this is we're 3 points clear of Charlton with two games to go. So all Charlton have to do is lose or we win, and then we should have secured the title. So I think that's something really, really important. We should be able to get the title in this episode. And finally, just at the top goal scorers, Gregory's top by 2 goals on 19 and O'Brien's 4 goals off of him. So if O'Brien wants to be within the top three, he has to start scoring goals. And obviously that would mean we have to start winning in games. So let's get into the team selection against Manchester City and let's hope we can go there and get a win. That is a big ask, though, considering we haven't won in 7 games in 90 minutes. Let's have a look at who we're playing. So really, we're going for a squad with strength in numbers. We've got Archer in goal, obviously the best goalkeeper we have. We have Webster and Hutchinson as the two centre-backs. The left-back is Sabori. I'm starting to like him a little bit more than I did in the past. Perhaps it's because he's gone up in a few ratings. The right-back is Cummins. The right midfielder is Fred. Two centre midfielders are Williams and Butcher, hoping they can get the job for us done. And then Ferguson is the left midfielder. And finally, Gregory and Ambrose leading the line to score the goals. Onto the bench, and we have Worrell, Chietri, Wild, O'Brien, Nelson, Shane Ward, and then Tom King. So hopefully these guys can help us by coming off the bench and creating an impact. But apart from that, let's just get into this game. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we can go and get something from this game. Mr. Friend, we've already got him through. Aguero! Great save by Jordan Archer there to keep us in this one. Already we're struggling. And we're probably going to be seeing a lot more saves if we are to have a chance in this game. But I'm just worried. Look at that. Otamendi, Archer with the save there again. It's going to be a long one, guys. Aguero. Yaya Toure in the centre of the pitch. He could find Sergio Aguero. Aguero with the shot. Archer with the save. And Cummins will get that away. We need to keep the ball away from our own area. We don't want too many of those happening. Sabori to Gregory. Gregory turns. Ambrose. Fred it through to Fred. Great save by Rulli. Oh, and he punches it over his own bar. I've never seen anything like it. The scenes here at Wembley Stadium in this semi-final. Catastrophic at the moment for both sides. Battle that ball away, and it could be Ambrose's chance to score. Oh my word, really is the guy that is keeping it clean at the moment at the back for Manchester City. And Sterling will go into the Gundogan through to Aguero. Archer with the save, outstanding, and it's gone for a corner. He is really playing like a Premier League keeper at the moment to stop the big giants in blue winning this game. And as it stands, the winner of this game would be playing Manchester United. I mean, Everton, chances are they're not getting that one back. So it probably will be United in the final. So hopefully one of us can buck our ideas up, get a goal and solidify who's going to Wembley again, this time to play for the FA Cup in the final. So let's go see how we're doing in this game so far. To be fair, it's actually been pretty interesting. I'm not going to lie, it's been one of my better games that I played in quite a long time. I mean, the amount of games we haven't really won. It's no coincidence that we're actually doing pretty well against City, though, because we're not a bad side, and we have given opportunities in the games that we haven't won to go on and do so. And, well, City, they're a strong side. They've got Aguero up front. That's a real big deal, and he's causing us some problems. Archer has been outstanding. I want full applause to go to this keeper if we manage to stay in this game for the full 90, because he is just pulling so many outstanding saves out of his locker. But we have got another 45 minutes. We can only hope that we're going to be able to get a goal. I mean, it is literally crunch time here, isn't it? We don't want to mess this up. Let's go. Let's see what we can do in this second half. We do have the substitutes, though they probably won't make a difference. On the free kick is Williams. We've just got to hit and hope. We do hit and hope, and it almost went in. My word. I was about to celebrate. You don't know how far that was from us just gliding through against Manchester City. Give it a go. Worrell laid off to Saborit. Still going. Enric Saborit with the shot. Really with the save. And how on earth do you go and miss that, David Worrell? We need to look at this again. Out of all the times that you expect someone to score an open goal, and he puts it galvanizingly wide. Frustrating, I know, because we could have won it there. Aiden O'Brien, who has the pace and energy, he's got him behind. Aiden O'Brien, don't make this a mistake, Aiden. Still going. O'Brien, really, with the save. How many times do I have to say that? What a move by Aiden. I mean, he's so close to scoring there, but yet so far. Keep going here. Ambrose. Aiden O'Brien. Flick through to Greg Wild. Still going. Greg. Still going. Greg Wild with the shot. It's gone in. Oh my word. We're beating Manchester City in the dying embers of the game. Who could have thought this? I mean, we have been outstanding all this game, but come on. Great move by Wild. He finally got in behind. We've been trying it all game, and it's finally paid off. We've got the lead against City. We could be going to the FA Cup final. How about that? Really, really looking forward to this one. We've just got to hold on to it now. Fingers crossed we can do. And that's Wild's first in the FA Cup. Who cares how many scored? He's got us the all-important goal in this one. It was a true performance from Millwall here. We really played at our best to beat City, and I'm so happy we did. Lucky though, we were very lucky, but we've got to win in 90 minutes. We can stop complaining about that one, and we can just go ahead and play Bury. I mean, playing Bury after playing Manchester City is nothing if you've just gone and beaten City. So let's just get into that team selection, and let's just hope we can go ahead and secure the title now. Make it two really big bits of news for Millwall Football Club. Right, and this is a team that's going to be playing Bury, a weakened side to the side we played against Manchester City quite clearly. They need to catch their match fitness for the final game in the league against Oxford. And maybe some of them won't even play in that because we've got Manchester United at Wembley in the final. I can only apologise for saying that the Etihad was where we'd be playing City. I forgot completely the fact that you'd go to Wembley for a semi-final. So let's just quickly look at the team we're playing. So Gunning goal, Craig and Hutchison as two centre-backs. The left-back is Joe Martin. The right-back is Marlon Romeo. Right midfielder, Paris Cohen-Hall. Two centre midfielders, Thompson and Fran Vilbala. A time to step up for Fran if he wants to win us this title. The left midfielder is Chris Twaddock. And two strikers are Sunil Chietri and Aiden O'Brien. And on the bench, we have Worrell, Gregory, Wild, Ambrose, Nelson, Ward and King. You know the drill. Let's get into this game and let's see what we can do. An attack for Bury, who could be through. What a save by Gunn. I mean, that's a save that you only ask your keeper to make. But that was outstanding, and that's keeping us in this. He's going to hit it if we don't stop him. Still going. Oh, and they're going to score. No, they're not. Wow, Gunn. The save that he made there was very important. I think you can understand that. And you know what? It's probably a goal. Let's tackle that there by Hutchison. And, well, I can only look in horror as they still haven't cleared it. It is really shambolic at the moment from our team. We're not defending very well. Bury, they could definitely take this one. Scores on the doors at half-time. Gillingham are beating Bradford City. And if you look one lower, Charlton Athletic are losing to Shrewsbury Town. The result that we needed to happen, because if they did, then we'd win the league. As long as we drew this one, then you've got another win. Let's just go for Oldham are beating Sheffield United. Apart from that, the rest of the results are there. You can see them yourselves. Let's have a quick little check how we're doing at the moment. Okay, so it's as I expected. Bury are the ones that are doing the damage. And, well, that's probably not going to change for this game. But as long as we keep it 0-0, it really doesn't matter. So let's get into the second half. More of the same, maybe. Hopefully, we can keep it the same result and win the title with a 0-0 draw. I mean, how tragic does that sound? But let's just get into the second half. Ben Thompson through to Ward. Ward in behind for Sunil Chietri, who stops. Still going. Chietri hits the post. Oh my word. If any, there's been a chance that we should have scored, it would have been that one. Through to Gregory. Lee Gregory. Played through to Sunil Chietri. Could he win the title for us? He can't yet. Hold the celebrations as Williams makes the save. Chietri looks like the guy that's going to be doing it, though. Well, it all really lies on Charlton to see how they did, but we really, really needed to win this game, and we didn't. So it is what it is, I guess. We've got another game, so we'll just go ahead and have a look how Charlton did and get into that team selection. I mean, we're more looking forward to the Man United game than drawing 0-0 with a team like Bury. But back to the usual business, though, which is bad to see, to be honest. Right, so this is the team that I'm going to be playing against Oxford United, the final league game of, obviously, this series completely. And so what we're going to do is we're going to show you the league at the end of this game so you can see what happened. I'm not going to deny or say that I've done anything because, obviously, add that suspense. Gunn is the goalkeeper that we're playing in this game. Want to thank him for his services. The centre-back is Hutchinson and Nelson there. Hopefully, they can do something. Rooney's the left-back. The right-back is Marlon Romeo. The right midfielder is David Worrell. He's complaining that he's not getting game time, which is fair enough. So we put him in the team. The two centre midfielders are Abdu and Ward. The left midfielder is Ferguson. And two strikers are Sunil Chietri, who impressed me a lot in the last game, and Thierry Ambrose. On to the substitute bench, and we have Paris Cohenhall, Lee Gregory, Greg Wilde, Aidan O'Brien, Tony Craig, Sean Williams, and Tom King. So, without further ado, let's go into this game, and hopefully we can actually win a game in League One. Or is that too much to ask for? I do not know. Let's have a look and see what we do. Brian Ledson, it's now with Robert Hall. Hall, still going. Great shot against the crossbar. We've now got to get it away if we want to keep ourselves not losing this game. Ward. Shane Ward tackled Abdu. What's he doing? I don't know, but he will find Sunil Chietri, who will not score. That's a surprise. I honestly thought he would put it in the back of the net there. He's really missed a good opportunity that should have given us a 1-0 lead. Tried to put it inside. I don't know what that was, but somehow it's found Ferguson on the back post. Shane Ferguson with the shot blocked. Ferguson chips the keeper and scores. I cannot believe that. How on earth did he not save that? Well, we're winning 1-0. Just about that. Ferguson sums it up. How on earth did we score that? Well, we have the lead. Probably not the best of ways ever, but we do have it. I don't understand how he's gone ahead and it's been blocked. It's come back to him and he's chipped the keeper from there. The keeper should be making a save, but nevertheless, it's a goal. And Ferguson don't always score them, so it's nice to see him get one here. And we do have the lead in this one. Could we hold on to a lead? You never know. It's been a while since we've been scoring goals in the league and holding on to leads, though. And that is Ferguson's fifth in the league. He's not always scoring, but five's not bad for a left midfielder. Ward again. Tried to thread it through. Chietri will then play it through to Ward, maybe. Yes, Ward still going. Could he score? Ward, what a save! He really wants a goal. And well, to be honest, he has been a very good youngster since coming through our youth ranks. This is where we want to have a goal from a corner if we can. Ward saved again. This keeper really doesn't want to concede another. Scores on the doors at half-time, and it's safe to say Charlton are drawing 0-0 with Northampton Town. That could be an interesting revelation for this game. You then got Fleetwood are beating Peterborough United, and then Bolton are beating AFC Wimbledon 2-1. So let's see how we're doing at the moment. So we are dominating in this game, which is fair to see. We're winning it 1-0. You kind of know what could happen if we win this game. So it's nice to see that we're actually winning it. So we've got a second half. We've got the lead. What could go wrong? Well, obviously, we all know that. So let's just get into the second half. Ward, he'll flick it in, hopefully for Ambrose. Oh, it doesn't work out, but it is to Ward now. Hits it first time. Wow, that would have been something else. And unfortunately, it is dealt with. She's hit to Gregory. Gregory flicks it to David Worrell, who could score. He does. There we go. It's 2-0. And I can safely say we're definitely winning the league now. So there we go, David Worrell with the goal, he's celebrating. He hasn't had that many games this season, so maybe it's a blessing in disguise for the lad. But You can see how much it means to the team. They know we've gone and we've won the league. And really, it's mathematically impossible now for Cheltenham to even go and get it. But obviously, if I let you into a secret, it was before. We're by miles, if Cheltenham mess it up, we're by miles winning the league. So this is something to celebrate about, you gotta be honest. And that is David Wall's first goal in the league. Doesn't score very many goals because he doesn't play. So there you go. He's rewarded me with scoring. And there you go. You can see how much it means to the fans because it has been confirmed that we've won the title. We are the champions of League One. Everyone here will be celebrating because you know what? We've done it in style. 2-0 against Oxford. I mean, they'll feel disheartened. We don't care what they feel. We've won the league. It's all that we cared about. We finally did it. We finally won a game in the league in 90 minutes. It took a very long time for that to happen. But you can see what this means to the players celebrating like mad. Some of these players aren't even players that have played that much this season. And they will all line up to go and lift this trophy, which we will have the build up to. See them all celebrating. Ward there, 16-year-old. Very, very hot prospect at this club. I'm really liking the look of him. He's been a fantastic player so far, and he could be something that could help us in the future. Obviously, got over there on the left, Aidan O'Brien, and here we go. Let's cut to lifting it. Hutchinson lifts it. There we go. We are in the championship, but we've done it in style. We've won the league, and there you go. I mean, I'm speechless now. I don't know what to say because it has been a long time coming, and there's been a lot of difficult moments for this football club to get there. I mean, the amount of draws we had to endure to get here, there's a lot that's happened in that time. And, well, we've done it against all the odds, technically. I mean, we are a good side, let's be honest. But against all the odds, we've gone and we've lifted this trophy. So, there we go. We've gone and we've lifted this trophy. And, well, we've got one more bit of silverware that we could be eyeing. Yes, that's right. The FA Cup. But first, let's go see the league table to see how far we succeeded. Right, so this is the league table. We won by 4 points to win the top of the league, being the champions of League One. Cheltenham go up with us. Bolton, Chesterfield, Sheffield United, Coventry, all four sides that are in the playoffs. So it'll be one of those that will be joining us in the championship. Obviously, Oxford wanted it, but they didn't beat us, so they couldn't get there. And moving down the table, Bradford City, Gillingham, teams that I would have expected to be in the top four weren't there. And then MK Dons just on the final day stayed up just about. Very, very lucky. Goal difference by one goal kept them in this league. That would have been something horrific if they had gone down. Shrewsbury, Anfield, Wimbledon, Walsall and Peterborough are the sides that do go down though. Peterborough and Walsall are sides that I thought were a lot stronger than getting relegated. But hey-ho, it is what it is. So let's get into this team selection against Manchester United at Wembley. Hopefully we can do it. Right, so this is the fourth and final team that we're playing in this episode. This ends the series for us. So we've gone with the strongest team, technically, that we can go for. So I'm quite happy with the squad we got here. Jordan Archer has gone up yet another rating, and he's a 71 rated. We've got the two centre-backs as Webster and Hutchinson. The left-back is Sabora, who's been pretty good when he's played recently. The right back is Cummins. The right midfielder is David Worrell. Two centre midfielders are Williams and Fran Vilbala. Left midfielder is Ferguson. Two strikers are then Aidan O'Brien and Thierry Ambrose. And that means we've got five players who are 70 rated or above, which is already good enough to be a championship side. And then looking on the substitute bench, Paris Coenhall, Lee Gregory, Greg Wilde, Sunil Chietri, who has literally been fantastic without scoring in the last couple of games, Tony Craig, Sean Ward and Tom King. Ward has been outstanding as well, so he deserves a place on the bench to come on as a substitute if I need him to. So, let's get into this game at Wembley Stadium against Manchester United. This could be something huge. Now we can move forward. Ambrose. Oh, and that was poor. It looks like we've still got it. Aidan O'Brien. Fran Vilbala. Oh, he's still going, Vilbala. Could he score in this game? Vilbala has. There we go. We have the lead against Manchester United. This is something only people can dream of. The guy that I've been slating all season, saying he's not good enough for Millwall because he hasn't been performing in the league, has just scored in the FA Cup. So this could be some redemption for the young lad here. We're beating United at Wembley. The scenes here are absolutely fantastic. I cannot wait to battle on in this game. Hopefully we don't lose it, but you know, they are a big side, so it would make sense. But it is game on, obviously. Chris Smalling tried his utmost very best, but he just got taken out by his own goalkeeper in the end. And that goal is good enough to give us a 1-0 lead over a very, very good football club. And that's Vilbala's first in the FA Cup. Matteo Darmian, can we enter it away? We can't, but Archer will just catch the ball and throw it up the pitch. And that was a poor throw, as now Martial will play it to Rooney, who scored already. It's game on, definitely. Wayne Rooney with an outstanding goal. I mean, seriously, wrong celebration from him there. Should not be doing that. That's Gareth Bowson. Well, that's really what happens when you do that sort of mistake. And, well, Archer should have done better with that. But what a cold effort by Rooney. He is really the leader. And I just see they have Harry Kane. Well, that definitely adds a sense of intrigue to what's going to happen in this game. But seriously, that was an outstanding strike. And wow, they deserve to be back in it already. And well, all that hard work of getting the lead has just been overturned by Rooney's second in the FA Cup. This is where we've got to defend. Hutchinson, you can't let Paul Pogba have space. Martial, it's been overturned already. United 2-1 up now. We've gone from heroes to villains as we're our own downfall. United just playing their normal football casually. We can't do nothing about it. We have been absolutely horrendous since scoring that goal. And, well, it's frustrating to see because you see the simple things are what we're getting wrong. Pogba never should have had that space. And Archer, well, he didn't stand a chance as soon as Martial got the ball at his feet. It really is frustrating, but there's not really much you can do. When your defence has fallen asleep, you really hope they can just actually just wake up, but they're not working. And, well, Mourinho has a right to celebrate. He's 2-1 up now. Obviously, we're going to give it our best, and we'll just have to try. Ambrose, through to Williams. Sean Williams, back to Ambrose. Thierry Ambrose, still going with it. Ambrose, could he have the shot? He can, he scored! My word, what a game this is turning out to be. 2-2 now, before half-time. Something that you just don't see, but Wembley are definitely getting their money's worth out of this one. 2-2. This has been a brilliant game compared to the one against Manchester City. But my word, Thierry Ambrose, he's a guy that loves the cups, and he's a guy that loves scoring in this cup. The FA Cup, he's scored about 4 or 5 goals now, and well, he's not the one to turn down this occasion. What a strike by the ex-Manchester City boy. And well, what a player to score against United, that's for sure. An outstanding strike, De Gea was well and truly beaten. And well, I'm not going to complain. That makes my team talk technically better at half-time. And as I said, that's Ambrose's fifth in the FA Cup. That is something else. A guy that's not scoring very many in the league, but he knows how to score in the FA Cup. Half-time here, and given the balance, you can tell the result should be the way it is. What a game so far. I mean, 2-2 at Wembley. Keeping up with the United, that's the way we like to do it. And well, it's an interesting game. Ambrose and Vilbala, two players that don't always score, are coming up and scoring some pretty important goals in this one. We've got a second half, you know the drill. Let's get into it. Let's see what we can do. Hopefully, we can get the right result. I mean, fingers crossed, this would be something else to lift 3 trophies in one season. They play it through for Ferguson, who's got in a lot of space here. Shane Ferguson still going, lays it through to Fran Vilbala, blocked, and it's gone for a corner in the end. Well, that is something we like to see. We've got to try and intercept it. We're still not intercepting it. Pogba's one to not shy away from an occasion. Rooney, 3-2. This is something we don't want to happen. It's been an outstanding game, so no matter what, it's been something that you can definitely celebrate about. Scoring 2 goals against United is something else, but it's this marking and letting them go 3 on their own. It's not what you do against United, and that's why there's been so many goals that they've scored in this game, because we just can't do that. We're a League One side, not a Premier League side, so keeping up with this team is very hard, but we'll give it a go, and we'll have to see how we can come back into this game. And we don't win it. United beat us 3-2. It's painful, but it is what it is. We just didn't mark Wayne Rooney for that goal. It's a shame, but getting to the final of a huge event, it's better than nothing, I guess. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this Millwall Career Mode journey for the first series. it's had its ups, it's had its downs. Quite clearly, you can see the downs there. But we've done well. We've got promoted. We've won the Checkatrade Trophy, and we've come runners up in the FA Cup, all within League One. So like, comment, subscribe, and of course, hopefully, I should be getting a double upload this week with the start of Season 2 of this career mode. We want to go in the Championship, we want to impress, and well, United are about to lift this trophy. So, like, comment, subscribe, and of course, I will see you guys for that double upload, but let's just see them lift it up. And there you go, they have won it. So, goodbye.